Hey there, I'm making a screencast just to show how to make a multicam edit. It sounds complicated, and why would you want to do this? So my use case is that I have some GoPro footage. Let's see if I can play this back for you. So what I'm doing here is that I'm taking a video of my face, and at the same time, I'm taking a screencast. So the idea is that I want to flip between the screencast of what's actually on my screen, so people can see what's on the screen, and then also have a look at my face. So the whole idea is that I create some sort of more personal sort of approach to learning how to use a particular function on my computer. I mean, I don't know about you, but I don't like videos where they just show you the screen all the time without the face. I'm trying to make it a little bit more personal. So here's the GoPro footage and here's the screencast. And actually, the screencast sort of starts a bit later, so I need to spend a little bit of time syncing them up. I'm just dragging it onto my timeline. And I think I start screencasting for about 2 minutes in, so I'm just going to drag that in over here. And then let me just play that back, move this thing, whatever it's called. So the screencast is actually less resolution than the original screencast, so I need to probably fix that. But I think I like that here, so just so I can see where I am. Okay, great. Switching to the desktop, that's probably where it all starts. Okay, it's probably not perfect, but I just want to move on quickly. So that's where it starts. Okay, I think there's a quick option to make it scale to frame size. Did that work? Yeah, it did. See, it's resized to the frame size. Okay, now we need to do the multicam edit. Multicam edit, multicam edit. This is a bit tricky. This is a bit tricky. So the way I'm told on the forum is to hold down Alt, and you select the video track, and then you select the other video track. But I find that you can't. Oh, Alt Shift. I can select two of the tracks. So great, I got two of the tracks, and then from there you create a nest, whatever that is. So both two videos. Yep, done that. And then you go multi-camera enable, Yahoo. And then I think we're set now. Let me just go to the front of that. Oh, I need to enable multi-cam view. If you don't have it here, you need to just go here, multi-camera. Okay. Oops. This is actually starting from the run in the beginning. Let me just go to about 2 minutes with a. Okay, so now we have it. We have the two videos right there. And the beautiful thing about this is that when you're playing back, you can just select which one you want to cut to. So you go da, 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 da. Let me go forward a bit. Oh, I mean, I really should be on the screencast right now. Okay. So now I'm on the screencast. Then I can flick back to myself. Okay, so you see there's a cut made there. And as the guy on the forum, pointed out, you can use also the nudge tool. You just press N to get it. And if you made an edit which wasn't sort of, I mean, if you clicked in the wrong place, you can actually use this sort of nudge tool to fix it up. And so this machine isn't the most powerful. So I was just playing back here. and you see, you just cut into it, and it works great. Probably going forward, I would probably mark where the screencast started, just to make my life easier. Another thing that I messed upon is that if you're relatively new to everything, and something doesn't show up, you probably are missing some sort of selection over here. This track targeting. That cost me a lot of time. In fact, this whole menu is a little bit, at least for me, I find it quite difficult to work with. And there's loads of weird tricks I guess I can only advise to spend some time making sure selections are on or off before going mental. One of the weirdest things I find is that if you want to see the waveform, you have to double click in this blank space before you get to see it. Not sure why that is. And of course, when you're working with video a lot, the waveforms are very important for making edits. Another thing worth mentioning is that my screencast unfortunately didn't have any audio track with it. I messed it up, so it would have been easier to synchronize this earlier if I had the audio track. Okay, well, I hope that multicam edit screencast / tutorial helped you a lot. There's one thing I should probably add, is that say you want to make an edit to one of the tracks, you can actually double click on the nest, which is in the project, and then you can add an effect to one of the video tracks. That drove me mad. I had it nested, and how do I make a change to the how do I scale it up or something? Because once they're nested, they're grouped. You can't really work on one track, but I've discovered by double-clicking on the nest, you get a new tab here, and you can make the edit. Phew. I think we've learned a lot today, haven't we? At least I have. If you have any other tips, please let me know. Thank you.